Welcome to this video on calling single nucleotide polymorphisms with Geneious Prime. To begin, you must prepare your contig document. See the map to reference video for how to do this. To find SNPs in the mapped data, select the contig file and go to Annotate and Predict, then Find Variations / SNPs. The options in the Find Polymorphisms section allow you to set the parameters for calling SNPs. These ensure disagreements that result from sequencing errors are filtered out. To learn more, select the Help buttons. I will leave these as default. Ensure you select Analyze Effect of Variance on Translations and change the default genetic code to that representing your sample. In this case, this is bacterial. Selecting to analyze effects on translations means Geneious will use the coding sequence annotations on the reference sequence to determine the coding sequence of the mapped reads. Geneious then calculates whether the observed SNPs will result in a change in the amino acid sequence. In the last section, you can adjust the p-value calculation method. You can also tweak additional settings by expanding the More Options tab. Once you're happy, click OK. You should now see an annotation track labeled Variance. Click Save and choose Yes when asked to apply changes to the original sequence. To learn more about a specific SNP, zoom in on an annotation in the Variance track and mouse scroll over a SNP of interest. The pop-up window contains information for that SNP, including the base change, variant frequency, SNP type, and information about the protein and coding sequence changes. To view this information in tabular format, switch to the Annotations tab, then change the type to Polymorphism to only view the SNP annotations. You can also adjust the data shown in the table by selecting columns and adding or removing the columns you want. Finally, you can export the table as a CSV file by selecting Export Table. That's an overview of how to call SNPs in Geneious Prime. To learn more, visit geneious.com.